not the horns of Gondor, and they rung it just to find Daigo somewhere lost amongst the sea of people here at CEO.
Oh,
that's a pretty solid Horn of Gondor.
Now Daigo getting ready to play on his hitbox versus the last chance for American players to make the winner's side top 8 in Duel Kevin.
Yeah, he is a SFL player, right? He was in that league the whole time, and I think he really performed super well there and has performed super well in all the CPT events I've seen him in since then, but this is definitely a big showing for him. Chance to make top 8 winner side at a premier event alongside just like legendary players.
Yeah, and don't forget, he's already 2K richer thanks to that SF League this weekend.
It's already been a good weekend so far. You know, you want to join the likes of Machabo, Bonchan, up in that top 8, get a chance against Fudo. These are like the kind of players you're fighting to play against, you know, and it just gets harder from there.
Yeah, so this is the last match to determine who's going to be on the winner's side of top 8. Again, as you mentioned, Bonchan, Machabo, and Fudo already there.
Yeah, those have been the last three matches we've had after. And right now, we're looking for our last qualifier on winner's side of top 8. Again, smash.gg, check out the brackets there.
Here we go, Daigo. Going in with that hitbox Guile.
Yeah, one thing that's important in this matchup is there's a range where you can throw booms, and if the Rashid player rolls through them, you can like sweep or hit a button to react to whatever they do. And that range, Daigo wants to hang out in a lot, because that's the range where you can just react to everything and play nice and slow.
I mean, if you're Duel Kevin, how do you feel right now going up against him? I mean, he's beating a lot of guys, so actually none of this should be pressure for him.
That was sick. He threw the V-reversal forward back into the corner. Big crush. And yeah, I mean, Duel Kevin's played plenty of good players. To make it here, he's played a lot of good players in his life. Working on Dizzy here. The V-reversal works. Gets him some space.
Daigo, you see, God, his fireball timing is immaculate. He's honed it ever since Street Fighter 2 with his Ryu fireball timing. It's so hard to get through it like that, but Duel Kevin actually manages to do it and now gets the life lead here in the first round and the second throw. Duel Kevin taking the first round over Daigo Umehara.
Yeah, I mean, that's the kind of player we're looking at here. He is comfortable. He knows what he's doing. He's already into this top 24 winner side. Like, there's no doubt that he's good enough to be here. It's just you got to take down someone who is, you know, a legendary opponent in a lot of ways and very, very good at adapting in situations like this. So that's what I want to see is what does Daigo do to change? What does Duel Kevin force Daigo to start to bring out? It's that down jab boom. One of the best down jab cancels in the game. Gives you plenty of space. Punish.
Ooh, he went for the wake up and Daigo got caught by it. Didn't believe quite yet. But that's going to make Daigo think about things a little bit more.
Daigo was trying to throw on that meaty. Activates and tries to jump out of the corner, maybe reading a throw. Big punish.
Here we go.
Can go for the 50-50 here. Stays in the front. Daigo with the V-reversal out. Another one there. Yep. A lot of gray life on Duel Kevin. The jab. It did a lot of damage as an anti-air because of it.
Okay, Daigo, I'm sorry, not Daigo, but Guile kind of has that similar thing to Karen. Doesn't really need the V-trigger for, you know, crazy comebacks. Can use it for a lot of V-reversals and still have the ability to win. You know, Karen just by having good pokes and damaging combos, but Guile just wears you down.
Yeah, and he also has, wow, the overhead. Second time we've seen him bring out that target combo when it's hit. One thing that, you know, Guile players do a lot too, especially Daigo, will do crashing medium kick and then crashing medium kick again into the target combo overhead. So try to see if you stand up or if you don't respect it the second time. EX boom catches the start. He dashes up for the throw, and one thing about Daigo is that he will go for pressure, right? He's not just gonna like back up and throw booms. He likes to run that offense when he can.
Ooh, got crushed. Perfect distance for that. Here we go, Duel Kevin now getting the throw into the corner. Oh no, Daigo flinched, and that's gonna be a stun. And that means Duel Kevin should potentially take game number one. Yes, there it is, Duel Kevin.
Yeah, clean gameplay too. I mean, he stood in that perfect range where if Daigo's going to throw booms, he's going to get crushed for it. You have to sit there and wait it out, push him out of that range, and then go for your, you know, kind of far normals, use other stuff like that. And Duel Kevin took perfect advantage. He's like, look, if you're not going to respect this range against Rashid, I'm going to hit Crouching Fierce, and you're going to get crushed all day.
Daigo thinking about what to do, and you can see down there, using the controller of the future.
Yeah, he's got the. Is that his phone sitting on top?
No,
of
there's
oh, that's
something.
Something blocking
yeah,
the view. Okay.
On the table. Yeah, I was wondering the same thing. I was like,
he has his
what
phone
is
on
that?
I was like, how is that possible?
Ooh, controller of the future.
Backing him up with the booms.
Year 2000. Nice.
And the front throw in the corner. Man, Dual Kevin has really just smothered him so far. He hasn't given Daigo any space.
Yeah, every time Dual Kevin manages to get Daigo into the corner, it starts to go down really fast for Daigo. Daigo hasn't been able to break himself out of the corner against Dual Kevin yet.
Bazooka need for some space, but activation. Rolls in for the plus frames in the beer reversal. Spends some bar for the knockdown and back dash again.
Back dash.
Yeah, Dual Kevin really hasn't felt any of this offense from Daigo so far. It hasn't been an issue. Nice little low check, too. So far, we really haven't seen Daigo get too much out of this kind of position. Upside
He's
down kick. Wow, two in a row.
Away. Look at this. He's already tied it up without taking basically any damage. Oh, God, with the overhead, but wasn't enough to kill. Watch out.
Didn't reach. Walked all the way up in his face, and the trade, he lived with just a bit.
Man, Daigo clutching that one out, and he had such a deficit too. But that's what I mean. Daigo and Guile just have the patience to wear you down one hit at a time like that.
Nice fierce buffer, the sweep after. Man, his upside down kicks are out of control. Dash up sweep? I wonder if he tried upside down kick. All right, front throw. No anti-air from Daigo. The counter hit, not enough to kill.
Close the stun, though. There it is, the stun. And that means Dual Kevin should be at match point. He does spend a bar just to be absolutely sure, and I like that decision. But he's going to come into this round with two full bars, only one less resource of a super meter than Daigo.
Man, I love that stand light kick buffer after. Cleans it up, Daigo with more pressure, and the EX mixer again on the throw that Daigo tried. Anti-air, and he hits a down jab on the way in, knows that Daigo didn't have enough for what he was trying to do, counter hit, dizzy.
Oh my gosh, how much damage can he do off of this? Probably gonna be, he doesn't spend any meter. He saves it, he gets the throw, not enough to kill. Daigo, still alive here. We've seen the comeback he was capable of. He did not do an EX flash kick afterwards. He's saving the meter for the EX Sonic Booms.
Yeah, I don't know.
Oh, too far for the throw.
He's got to be careful here. Whip button from Daigo. Got him. Not in range. He didn't do EX boom either.
Oh, my God. Dual Kevin with the fireball at the last second to block. Here
Try
we go.
Trying to pick him out. Rolls in. Daigo with the break.
Overhead!
Daigo Umehara comes back and ties it up one apiece.
And that nod from Daigo is like the most emotion I've ever seen or reaction I've ever seen from him at a tournament.
He was like, yeah, I'm back. You thought you could kill me so easily? Not like this. Daigo staying alive here in this top 24 winner's sign.
Wow.
And if you're Dual Kevin, that is rough. He could have hit any button, but Daigo just broke the throw and said overhead. The slowest thing he could have done. And he's just living on a pixel. Dual Kevin could have hit crouching light kick. Crouching
definitely kick. Just a read from Daigo that Dual Kevin is probably, you know, either nervous or just, you know, tentative.
He wasn't going to hit anything.
Yeah, didn't want to just get hit.
Walks back, and that's patented Daigo. Walking back out of his opponent's pressure and then getting the down jab is like 90% of his defense right there is off the strength of that. Baited. That was really clean. He used the standing medium punch to fake a sonic boom, and then when Dual Kevin rolls in, punish with a target combo. Crouching light kick, medium fierce.
Ooh, okay. Heavy spinning mixer, but now the EX flash kick from Daigo finally busted out after nowhere. After a long time of not doing any wake up EX flash kicks.
There it is. Stuffs the dash.
Good awareness from Dual Kevin. Knew that Daigo was going to try to switch the defense to offense that way. Full damage combo.
Uh-oh, working on Dizzy here. Veer Russell from Daigo, love that choice. Walks up, looks for the upside down kick, hoping Dual Kevin would stay in place in tech. EX boom to beat it. Walking him down. You see Daigo's not even backing up. He's just trying to walk up and really check Dual Kevin in that space, not let him throw the fireballs. Uses the EX to clash again. Man, he is playing this.
Oh man, no anti-air. Dual Kevin trying to figure out a way to get kill, and he does it again! No fear from Daigo! How many overheads at the end of these rounds has he gone with?
He's just feeling it. He's like, yep, this is the right choice. Goes in again. Ooh, try to whip punish a little late. Roll kick, perfect.
And you know, it's just
what Daigo has been trying to throw or hit buttons on every time. And yeah, Daigo's, you know, he has like a really solid kind of game plan here. And you can tell that Dual Kevin is being forced to adjust. After that first game didn't go his way, his dashes are surprising too. They just come out of nowhere. That was a bait. Didn't get punished. Big jump.
Pretty even on life here right now.
Had to sweep. Yeah, he wasn't in range for crouching medium punch, so. Good choice from Daigo. That's good recognition of the situation, and he's got full resources. Man. This is scary. And now, you don't want to roll in and eat something big, but EX off the table.
Now Daigo with the lead. Okay, but Dual Kevin getting as much damage as he can.
Yes.
Oh, catches the backdash.
Daigo with V-Trigger available. Sweep into V-Trigger is very good. So is the boom into V-Trigger. Wow, catches him jumping. V-Reversal.
So no more V-Trigger activations.
Daigo's pressing!
Oh my god, not enough to kill! Overhead, overhead, is it gonna happen again?
He can't, if he overheads again. Goes low! He walked up and went low, Daigo! He thought he went low again!
Oh,
Dual Kevin low blocking
with the EX! Sonic boom!
Daigo Umehara in top 8 winners of CEO. Dang, Daigo looked at him and was like, good games. Like, he gave him like, I don't think I've seen Daigo hit somebody with like the GG's, man.
Good job, kid. You did good.
You did well, kid. You fought against Daigo and you fought valiantly.
The crazy thing about it is if he had gone for another overhead, it would have worked.
It would have worked. Dual Kevin, he has blocked left, right, upside down. Crazy stuff on the screen. But in Street Fighter, man, you bring out the bajillion frame overhead, and sometimes it just be like that.
I mean, I tell you, though, shout outs to Dual Kevin. What an awesome performance so far. He's still here. He's still in this. So it's not done for him at all by any stretch of the imagination. But, you know, now that we have the top 8 winner side, it's going to be Daigo, Monchan, Machibo, and Fudo, 4 Japanese players.
Awesome.
But we've got a ton of losers bracket matches to go through still. So don't go.